Good morning, students. Today I am going to explain the second part of lesson number 3, Cultural Heritage of India, Sculpture and Architecture. Today I am going to explain the following points. Harappan civilization, the cities of Dholavira and Lothal, Mauryan art, stupa of Sanchi, pillar inscription, pillar at Sarnath and a stone inscription. Harappan civilization. Take out your textbook and write down the questions in the textbook. Give information about the Harappan civilization. So this Harappan civilization, it was discovered by Dayaram Sahni under the leadership of Sir John Marshall and Colonel Maker from Montgomery in Punjab district near Harappa in 1921. So who discovered Harappan civilization? It was discovered by Dayaram Sahni under the leadership of Sir John Marshall and Colonel Maker from where? From Montgomery in Punjab district near Harappa in 1921. And this civilization is called the Harappan civilization because its remains were first found from Harappa. And it is also known as Indus Valley civilization because this culture was found on the bank of the river Indus. And it is this region is also known as the Sapta Sindhu region. And the remains of this Indus Valley civilization were found from Rapper in Himalayan region, Alamgirpur at Meerut, Dholavira, Rangpur near Limdi in Saurashtra, Srinathgat near Gondal, Kundasi near Morbi, Somnath, etc. So give information about a Harappan civilization. Who discovered a Harappan civilization? It was discovered by Dayaram Sahni under the leadership of Sir John Marshall and Colonel Maker in 1921 from Montgomery in Punjab district near Harappa. And where were the remains of this civilization found? From the Rapper in Himalayan region, Alamgirpur at Meerut, that is in Uttar Pradesh. From Gujarat, Dholavira, Rangpur near Limdi, Saurashtra, Srinathgat near Gondal, Kundasi near Borbi, Somnath, etc. And what is the other name of this Harappan civilization? Sapta Sindhu region. And why it is called a Harappan civilization? Because it was first found from Harappa. And the culture developed on this on the bank of the river Indus. That is why this civilization is also called Indus Valley civilization. So it is said that the people of this civilization belong to copper stone age. Why? Because copper and stone weapons and many other things were found from that this region. So in which age that people of Harappan civilization belong? They belong to copper stone age. Why? Because the copper and the stone weapons and many other things were found from this region. And the town planning of Harappan civilization was systematic, means well planned and arranged. And its granaries and forts were remarkable. Granaries means the place where that storeroom where that grains are stored or kept. Grains means rice, wheat, etc. are kept. Forts means killas. And the people of that age were fond of wearing ornaments. How we can say that people of that age were loved to wear that ornaments? Because we got many ornaments from these places. So give information about Harappan civilization. Who discovered Harappan civilization? It was discovered by Dayaram Sahni under the leadership of Sir John Marshall and Colonel Maker from Montgomery in Punjab near Harappa. And what is the other name of this civilization? That Indus Valley civilization. Why it is called Indus Valley civilization? Because it developed on the bank of the river Indus. And why it is called Harappan civilization? Because the remains of this civilization was first found from Harappa. And this region is also known as Sapta Sindhu region. That in which age that people of Harappan civilization lived. That copper stone age. How can we say that? Means the people of Harappan civilization belong to that copper stone age because many copper and stone weapons and many other things were found from this region. How was the town planning of Harappan civilization? It was very systematic. And its granaries and forts were remarkable. How can we say that people of Harappan civilization were fond of wearing ornaments? We have got remains of ornaments from many places in Harappa. Then this is the remains of that Harappan civilization. The next one is give information about Dholavira. A huge and a systematic ancient town, contemporary. Contemporary means existed at the same time when that Harappan civilization was there. Has been found or discovered from 2 kilometers away from Dholavira village at Kadirpet in vast desert of Bachau Taluka, which is about 140 kilometers away from Bhuj. So where is Dholavira situated? At Kadirpet in vast desert of Bachau Taluka, about 140 kilometers away from Bhuj in Gujarat. And who discovered this Dholavira? It was discovered by the officers of Archaeological Survey of India under the guidance of Ravindra Singh Bisht in 1990. And they have also found that a palace and a main town. And a palace and walls in the main town were painted with the white color. Yeah, strong fortification around the town suggests a strong security. So they have found a highly raised walls around the town. That shows that they give more importance to that protection or security. And how they constructed the fortification by using that stone, bricks and clay. And there was also arrangement for purification and filtration of water. And this Dholavira was a, from this we can say that Dholavira was a systematically well-planned town it was. So give information about Dholavira, where it is situated. It is situated 2 kilometers, it is situated at Kadirpet in vast desert of Bachau Taluka, about 140 kilometers away from Bhuj. So where is Dholavira situated? It is situated at Kadirpet in vast desert of Bachau Taluka, about 140 kilometers away from Bhuj. Who discovered Dholavira? It was discovered by the officers of Archaeological Survey of India in 1990 under the guidance of Ravindra Singh Bisht. And what were the things they have? They had found out that a palace, main towns and a fortification. How was the palace and the walls of the main towns were painted? They were painted with the white color. And they had also discovered a strong fortification around the town. That shows that they gave more importance to protection or security of their town. And what were used for the construction of fortification? Stone, bricks and clay. And there was also arrangement for the purification or filtration of water. From this we can say that Dholavira was a systematically planned town. These are the remains of that Dholavira. Then Lothal. Write down in your textbook the question, Lothal was an important port of Gujarat. Explain. So where is Lothal situated? It is situated in Dholka Taluka of Ahmedabad district. So where is Lothal situated? It is situated in Dholka Taluka of Ahmedabad district. And Dholka, it is a place between two rivers. So this Dholka is situated in between two rivers. Which are the two rivers? Bogavo and Sabarmati. And where it is situated? 18 kilometers away from Bay of Kambath, and there they had discovered three layers of a human habitat, three layers in which people used to live over there. That a huge dockyard. Dockyard means an area which is used for for repairing and maintaining of a ship, was constructed to facilitate the ships in the time of high tides at the lower eastern part of the town. So a huge dockyard also had was found in Lothal. What was the use of that dockyard? It was used to facilitate the ships at the time of high tides at the lower eastern part of the town. And such dockyards, so many shops also were found. This shows that it was the center of trade in ancient time. There took place of export and import. And it shows that Lothal was a rich and a prosperous port of India. So Lothal was an important port of India of Gujarat. Explain. Where is Lothal situated? It is situated in Dholka Taluk of Ahmedabad district. Dholka, it is situated in between two rivers. Which are the two rivers? That Bogavo and Sabarmati. Where is Lothal situated? 18 kilometers away from Bay of Kambath, and they had discovered three layers of a human habitat, and a huge dockyard also was constructed to facilitate the ship at the time of high tides at the lower eastern part of the town. And such a dockyard storage shops shows that it was the center of that trade. There took place export and import. This suggests that Lothal was a rich and a prosperous port of ancient India. This is that here showed that is a first layer, that small houses are there, that is the first layer. Second, that big houses, they are big, they are the group of shops. Third one, water, that is that dockyards are there. So three layers of a human habitat was found at Lothal. The next one is a Mauryan art. That a Mauryan empire was a was established by Chandragupta Maurya. The most famous Mauryan king was that King Ashoka. So who founded that Mauryan empire? It was founded by Chandragupta Maurya. Who was the most famous Mauryan emperor? King Ashoka. He was the first king who got the title emperor. So during his time, that emperor Ashoka, after the battle of Kalinga, he accepted that Buddhist religion. So he did a lot for the spread of that Buddhism. And the temple which was built, the temple of Buddhist religion is called a stupa. So write the meaning of a stupa. So who established a Mauryan empire in India? Chandragupta Maurya. Who was the most famous Mauryan emperor? That King Ashoka. And who was the first king of India who got the title emperor? King Ashoka. So during the time of King Ashoka, after the battle of Kalinga, he accepted, embraced that Buddhist religion, and he did a lot for the spread of Buddhist religion. During his time, that many temples were built. Those temples of Buddhism came to be called a stupa. Then write in your textbook this question, write the meaning of a stupa. An oval-shaped construction under which the remains of a Lord Buddha's body were kept in a box is known as a stupa. So that a Buddhist temple is called a stupa. It is a oval in shape and under which they had kept the remains of a Lord Buddha's body, like his nail, teeth, hair, bones, ashes were kept in a box. That is called a stupa. And during the time of King Ashoka, 5 stupas were built. They were that a stupa of Sanchi, stupa of Sarnath, stupa of Bairat, stupa of Nandangad, stupa of Devani Muri in Gujarat. So how many stupas were built during the period of King Ashoka? 5 stupas. Which were they? That stupa of Sanchi, stupa of Sarnath, stupa of Bairat, stupa of Nandangad, stupa of Devani Muri in Gujarat. And besides that, during his period, that Chaityas. Chaityas means a big hole in the stupa is called Chaityas. Then Viharas. Resting place of that Buddhist monks is called Viharas. Muds. The living place of that Buddhist monks are called Muds. They were also constructed. And the period of King Ashoka was called the golden period of a Buddhist religion, because so many stupas, chaityas, viharas and mutts were constructed during his period. And he did a lot for the spread of a Buddhist religion. That is why that period is known as the golden period of a Buddhist religion. It was the age of a sculpture and architecture. So write the meaning of stupa. What is meant by stupa? An oval shaped construction under which the remains of a Lord Buddha's body, like teeth, nail, hair, ashes, bones, etc., were kept in a box is known as a stupa. How many stupas were built during the period of King Ashoka? 5 stupas. Which were they? Stupa of Sanji, stupa of Sarnath, stupa of Bairat, stupa of Nandangad, stupa of Devani Mori in Gujarat. And besides that, Chaityas, Viharas and Mutts were constructed. And which period is known as the golden period of a Buddhist religion? That period, the King Ashoka's period is known as the golden period of a Buddhist religion. Why? Because during his period, stupas were built, then Chaityas, Viharas and Mutts were also constructed, and he gave encouragement to that Buddhist religion. He did a lot for the spread of a Buddhist religion. That is why that period was called the golden period of a Buddhist religion. Then stupa of Sanchi. That write up in your write down the question in your textbook. Right, about the stupa at Sanji. And that stupa Sanji also was built during the Mauryan period, during the period of King Ashoka. And where it is situated in Madhya Pradesh. And original stupa, it was made of bricks. And when it was built, it was half in size. Later, it was its area was doubled. And it is the best example of Buddhist architecture. So where is that Sanji stupa situated? It is situated at Madhya Pradesh. When it was built during the period of Mauryans. And the original stupa was how that original stupa was made. It was made of bricks. It was half in size compared to the present stupa. Then, which is the best specimen of Buddhist architecture? That is a Sanji stupa. So, what you will write about that stupa at Sanji? The stupa at Sanji was built during the Mauryan period. Where it is situated? It is situated in Madhya Pradesh. Original stupa was made of bricks, and it was a half in size compared to the present stupa. Its size was doubled later. Now it is a precious, valuable specimen of example of a Buddhist architecture. This is that Sanji stupa. It is situated at Madhya Pradesh. It was built during the Mauryan period, during the period of King Ashoka. And it was half in size compared to that present stupa. And its area was doubled. How it was made? It was made of bricks. And it was half in size compared to the present stupa. It is the best specimen of Mauryan architecture. Then linear sketches of a stupa, that means different parts of that stupa. First one is a harmika. Harmika means a railing around the top of the oval shaped, that railing around the top of that oval shaped, that stupa is called that harmika. So what is harmika? The railing around the top of the oval shaped stupa is called harmika. Then so in board exam, they will ask that this linear sketches of stupa in that object is or answer in one word. That is, what is the railing around the top of the oval shaped stupa called? Harmika. So that what is harmika? The railing around the top of the oval shaped stupa is called harmika. The next one is a medhi. Medhi is this one is. This is that medhi. Elevated circular path around the stupa is known as a medhi, and it is used for pradikshana. So what is that medhi? Elevated circular path around the stupa is called that medhi. Elevated circular path around the stupa is known as a dash, medhi. And for what purpose it is used? It is used for pradikshana. And third one is a pradikshana path. When we are going to the temple, we are taking the rounds to fulfill our wishes. That in odd numbers, we are taking the pradikshana or taking round of the temple. 1, 3, 5, 7, like that. So that path is called a pradikshana path. We are doing the pradikshana in such a way that the places of worship is always to the right side. So what is that pradikshana path? A slightly elevated circular path around the temple or place of worship is called pradikshana path. Pradikshana is done in such a way that a place of worship is always to the right side. Then toran. Toran means entrance of that. This is the entrance of that stupa is called that entrance of the stupa is called a toran, and it is a gateway that is built on high pillars. It is and with the horizontal that beam on it, and the devotees use this toran as an entrance. So what is the entrance of that Buddhist stupa called a toran? How it is built? It is built on two high pillars with artistic horizontal beam on it. So what is the entrance of that stupa called a toran? Then pillar inscription. So in ancient time, that paper was not there. Papers were not invented in ancient time. So in order to give the messages or in order to give the orders, that kings used to write on that walls of the caves, on that pillars, stones, etc. So writing with the writing on that pillar, stone, walls, etc. That is called an inscription. How they used to write? They used to write with the pointed sticks, nails, etc. So writing on that that pillars, that is called a pillar inscription. So give information about a pillar inscription. Write in your textbook the question. So the Mauryan emperor Ashoka started the practice of that writing his religious orders on specially made that pillars. So I have showed here that pillar inscription. So who started the practice of that engraving religion means writing on that writing his religious orders on erected pillars, that King Ashoka. And this so writing on that means stones, pillars, etc. That is called engraving. It is called so the pillar inscription, that is the best specimen of engraving on stone. And the pillars that they were made from a single rock and they were polished in such a way that from long distance also they shine like a glass. So what was the speciality of this pillar inscription? They were made from a single rock and they were polished so well that from long distance also it shine like a glass. And that these orders, religious orders, were written in which script? That Brahmi script. Script means a written language is called a script. Spoken language is called a dialect. So in which script that these religious orders were engraved or written? In that Brahmi script. That pillar inscription of King Ashoka were found from many places. At Ambala, Allahabad, Sarnath, Loria, Sanchi, Kashi, Patna, and Bodh Gaya. So give information about a pillar inscription. Who started the practice of that writing religious orders on that specially erected, made pillars? King Ashoka. And which are the best specimen of the art of engraving on stone? Pillar inscription. What are the specialities of this pillar inscription? They were made from single rock and they were polished in such a way that they shine like a glass. And in which script these religious edicts were written? In Brahmi script. In which places such pillar inscriptions of King Ashoka were made? At Ambala, Allahabad, Sarnath, Loria, then Sanji, that Kashi, Patna, and Bodh Gaya. And the most spectacular among these pillars is that one pillar at Sarnath. At the top of the pillar, there is the figure of four lions facing four directions. But we can see only three lions because one is at the back. And what is the importance of this Sarnath? It is the first place where Lord Buddha gave his religious teaching to his people. And the Dharma Chakras are also carved below that lion images, showing the victory of a Buddhist religion. In addition to this, we can find the figures of elephant, a horse, and a bull that are carved at the bottom of that figure of that lions. And the Dharma Chakra finds a place in our national flag. The middle of our national flag, that Dharma Chakra is there, and that figure of four lions has been accepted as our national emblem of India. So what is the speciality of which is that pillar is the most famous? The pillar at Sarnath. And whose figure is there in the pillar at Sarnath? The figure of four lions facing four directions. What is the importance of Sarnath? It is the first place where Lord Buddha gave his religious teachings to his disciples. And below that figures of four lions, there is a Dharma Chakra. And that shows the victory of a Buddhist religion. In addition, the figures of elephant, horse, and bull also have been carved at the bottom of the figures of lions. Where we can find this Dharma Chakra? On the national flag. And which is the national emblem of India? The figure of a lion. This is that national emblem of India, that figure of four lions. You can see only three, one is at the back. Then stone inscription. So during that time, they used to write on that stones also. So stone inscription carved by the religious orders of Emperor Ashoka are the best specimen of engraving on stone. So besides that pillars, Emperor Ashoka carved that Emperor Ashoka had used that stones also for giving religious orders to the people. and that a wooden art, a stone sculpting show an excellent specimen of art and architecture, along with erection of a wood and a stone. Beautiful arts are engraved on the door, which stresses religious behavior. So wooden art, making that furniture from wood, then that making the figures on that statues, that sculptures on that stone, murtis on that stone, that also shows the excellent specimen of the development of art and architecture. We can also see that sculptures were made on that wood and stone, and arcs were made, and means on that doors also we can see that different pictures that shows the religious importance. And such stone inscriptions, they have been found from Peshawar, Dehradun, Thane, Mumbai, Dauli, Jagauda, and Chennai. So where are the stone inscriptions are found in India? Peshawar, Dehradun, then Thane, Mumbai, Dauli, Jagauda in Odisha, and Chennai. Such a type of stone inscription has been found from the foothill of Girnar Mountain on the way to Junagadh in Gujarat. So in Gujarat also such a that stone inscriptions were found from the foothill of Girnar Mountain on the way to that Junagadh. Other than that, this Palitana Jain temples, that this type of stone inscription have been found from that Palitana Jain temples on Shatranjay Mountain in Gujarat. That Jain temple of Hathi Singh in Ahmedabad, which was made in 1847, that are such stone inscriptions which provide a complete information about the Sanskrit and Gujarati language. So in Gujarat also we can find such that stone inscriptions where we can find at the foothill of Girnar Mountain on the way to Junagadh, then Palitana Jain temples, then Jain temple of Hathi Singh in Ahmedabad. So in which language they have been carved in Sanskrit and Gujarati language. This is that stone inscription, sir.